Hello dear students, as you all know, we are doing chapter number 2, electrostatic potential in capacitance. In the last lecture, we have discussed about equipotential surfaces. Today, we are going to start a very important topic, and that topic is relation between electric field and potential gradient. Relation between electric field and potential gradient. Now, what is electric field? That we have discussed in the chapter number 1. But what is potential gradient? That we don't know. But while teaching the property of equipotential surface, we discussed the point that the strength or intensity of electric field is inversely varies to the separation between equipotential surfaces. That is, I have told you that the distance between two equipotential surfaces is the measure of electric field in that region. If the surfaces are very close to each other, then electric field is strong. But if the surfaces are very far away from each other, then electric field is weak. So basically, electric field varies as the separation between two equipotential surfaces varies. This we have discussed in the last lecture. Moreover, as you can see, suppose this is an equipotential surface, okay, and this is another surface, and the distance between these surfaces are something. Now, this is called an equipotential surface because at each point of the surface, the electric field is same. Electric potential is same. Here also, suppose here the potential is V1, here the potential is V2, and here the distance is D. So basically, V1 minus V2, which is what? Delta V. Delta V upon D. Say delta D. So this delta V upon delta D is called potential gradient. Change in potential with respect to distance. This is called potential gradient. So that we have understood that if the D varies, if D is greater, then electric field is smaller for constant potential difference, of course. If D is greater, then electric field is smaller. If D is smaller, then electric field is greater. That for that, delta V should be constant. But what is the exact relation for electric field and delta V upon delta D? This is all about under this topic, which is relation between electric field and potential gradient. So let us start our main topic, that is relation between electric field and potential gradient. As I have told you, the variation of potential with respect to distance, it is called potential gradient. Okay? So let us suppose that here is a charge capital Q, and from capital Q there are two points. One is point A and one is point B, and the separation between the points is dr, right? At B the potential is V, and at A the potential is V plus dV. What I am trying to say, the variation of potential from B to A is dV. And from B, when we reach to A, the potential increases because obviously the distance from the Q decreases. And potential due to a point, we have already studied KQ by R. The separation from the Q of A is less. That's why the potential at A is higher. Now, suppose a charge Q0 is carried from B to A, or charge is carried from B to A. Now, if the charge is carried from B to A, the external force which have to be applied, that must be in the same direction. In this direction, B to A only. But the electrostatic force which is acting at the point which is there, it is in the in this direction. Okay? It is the electrostatic force, that is Fe only. Right? But we make sure that F external is, the magnitude of F external is equal to Fe only, so that the net force acting on the charge Q0 is zero and it goes from B to A with constant velocity, so that there is no change in kinetic energy and all the changes will be there in the potential energy only. Now what will be the work done? The work done to carry Q0 from B to A, and that work done we are calculating by external force, not by internal force, right? So by external force, what will be the work done? The formula for the work done, dW, will be equal to what? Force, which is external, multiplied by distance, that is your dr. Is it clear? Force external multiplied by dr, F external and dr in same direction. Is it clear? Okay? The body is moving from there to there. So dr is in this direction only. Is it clear? Now, the F external can be written as, since F external is equal to Fe, direction is opposite, but the magnitude is same. So in place of F external, what we can write? Minus F electrostatics into what? dr. And F electrostatics can be written as dW is equal to minus Q0 into E vector into dr vector. Okay? Fe is equal to what? Qe. That is the formula. Let this be question number 1. Okay? For the work done, we have one more concept, and the concept is change in potential. I have already told you that. Also, if you remember, work done to carry a charge from B to A is equal to Q0. If it is written VA, we have to write VA minus VB. Okay? So from the same, this is the formula we have to apply. So dW will be equal to what? Q0. Potential at final point, VA. From initial to the final, V final minus V initial. What is V final? V plus dV. And what is V initial? That is V only. So V and V will be cancelled out, and we are going to have dW is equal to Q0 into dV. Let this be equation number 2. Now from equation 1 and 2, they both are telling the same value, which is of the work done. So what we can write? We can write that minus Q0 E vector dot dr vector is equal to Q0 into dV. Q0 and Q0 will be cancelled out. We have a very important formula, that is dV is equal to minus E vector dot dr vector. And from here, we can write E vector is equal to minus dV upon dr. If it is E and dr are in same direction, I am taking the case when E and dr are in same direction, they make the angle of 0 degree, and because of that, as seen in this case also, the direction of electric field will be in this direction only. Okay, so according to it, we have to put minus cos 180 degree. According to that, we have to solve. But here, I am taking a case when E and dr are in same direction, so we are going to have E is equal to minus dV upon dr. E is equal to minus dV upon dr. So this is the relation. Remember, it is the case when E and dr are in same direction. Okay? Is it clear? So E is equal to minus dV by dr. This is the relation we need. This is the relation what we were looking for. E is equal to minus dV by dr, which is E is what? Electric field. dV by dr is what? Change in potential with respect to distance, which is called electrostatic potential gradient. Okay? Electric potential gradient. So this is the relation, and from the relation we need to take something so that we can understand. Let me remove all these. You have to note down from the board only. Okay, pause the screen, note it down. Now let us move ahead. What are the points we need to take? There are two very important points, two very important conclusions from the last formula, and one very important conclusion from the second last formula. Let us discuss about the last one first of all. What we have got? We have got E is equal to minus dV by dr. Okay? E is equal to minus dV by dr. The first point we learn from here is the intensity, or simply we write electric field only, the electric field at a point is equal to negative of potential gradient at that point. Okay, electric field at the point is equal to negative of potential gradient at that point. This is the first output from the formula. And the second is the direction of electric field, the direction of electric field is in the direction in which the potential decreases the steepest. What is that steepest? Steepest means sharp. Okay, like suppose if this is the charge capital Q, okay, what this point means, and here at a point we need to know, okay, where is the direction of electric field. Okay, how we can calculate from here? Just try to understand that if from this point we go this direction, then also electric field decreases. If we go in this direction, then also electric field potential decreases, sorry. Okay, because the distance from the charge obviously increases. This distance is r, then obviously this distance is greater than this one. This great distance is greater than this one. If we go in this direction, then also distance increases. If we go in any of the direction, then distance, what happens? Distance increases, and because of that potential decreases, because potential is equal to what? Kq by r. Simple. But in the direction in which potential decreases the sharpest, in the direction in which the potential decreases the sharpest, the decrease in the potential is the most, then in that direction only the electric field will be. And from simple logic you can understand, if we go a distance in this direction, then distance increases on the larger rate in this direction. And if the distance increases, then what happens? Potential decreases. Is it clear? So these are the two important outcomes from this formula. And one more important point is there, and that very point is here only. From the mathematics we can understand, if somewhere the value of E is known and at that point dr is also known, then we can calculate the change in potential. And the change in potential is given by dv v1 to v2 is equal to minus E vector dot dr vector. Obviously we will take from r1 to r2. Is it clear? Okay, so this is what the value of change in potential need to be calculated from the formula. Okay, this is a very important formula. Sometime its application is given in the question, and sometime due to one configuration electric field is there and you have to find the change in potential. Okay, let us solve some questions so that we can understand this concept. Okay, there is a question. In this question, an electric field is given. The value of electric field is 5 into 10 to the power 3 Newton per coulomb. In this electric field, there are 3 points A, B, C, which makes a right angle triangle. Hypotenuse is 5 cm, this side is 3 cm. What is being asked? Find the potential difference between potential difference between A and B. This is the first part. Okay. Second part is B and C. And third part is A and C. Okay. We need to find out the potential difference between A and B, B and C, and A and C. Okay. Let us try to understand. From A to B, we need to know what is potential difference, that is your dV, which is equal to minus E times into dr. Let us write in vectors also. Okay. From potential difference A and B, if you consider A as initial point, B as final point, then the direction of movement will be in this direction only, and it makes an angle of 0 degree. From A to B, the direction of movement will be in this direction only, which is parallel to the electric field. The angle between E and dr will be 0 degree. So basically dv will be equal to what? Minus the value of E is 5 into 10 to the power 3, and the value of AB, this is 5 cm, this is 3 cm. Then obviously this is 4 cm. 4 into 10 to the power minus 2 converted in meter into cos 0 degree, which is 1. 5 4s are 20 multiplied by 10 to the power 1, which is equal to what? Minus, minus sign is missing, 200 volt. So this is the answer for A and B. Second, B and C. If we consider B as initial point, then basically dr makes an angle of 90 degree with the electric field, and therefore the dv will be minus E vector dot dr vector. Okay, minus E vector dot dr vector. Since they are making 90 degree angle, so it will be E dr cos 90, which is equal to what? 0. So basically dv is equal to 0. Means there is no potential difference between B and C, and in that manner we can say that B and C are on an equipotential surface. Because there is no potential difference, obviously they are in equipotential surface. Now for A and C. Third part. For A and C. How we can solve for A and C? Just see, dV is equal to what? Minus E vector dot dr vector. The value of E is 5 into 10 to the power 3. The value of dr is, what is dr? What is dr? It is 5. If suppose this angle is theta, okay, the direction of dr with the electric field is theta. So what is the component of 5 along this? The component will be 4, and this component will be equal to 3. 3 and 4, when they will be added, it will be equal to 5. So basically, when we write E dr cos theta, so basically dr cos theta is equal to what? In this question, it is equal to 4 cm. This one. Is it clear? So basically multiply by 4, and we have 4 into 10 to the power minus 2 as the same minus 200 voltage. Is it clear? Okay. And also B and C are in fact same potential. The difference between A and B and the difference between A and C will remain same. As you can see here also, the difference between A and B, it is minus 200 volt. The difference between A and C is also is 200 volt. Okay. So this is how the values are compared. Okay. Let us solve another one. Next question is from NCERT. It is question number 2.34. And the question is, describes the equipotential surfaces corresponding to a constant electric field in Z direction. Okay. Now what you have to do, we have to describe the nature of equipotential surfaces. And the first question is, the electric field is constant. Okay, the electric field is constant and it is in Z direction. The electric field is along Z direction, electric field is in this way. And if the electric field is in this way, then the equipotential surfaces will be like this. Okay, perpendicular to Z axis, and they will be placed equidistant. The distance between two equipotential surfaces will remain same. So this will be the answer of the first one. The second one says that a field that uniformly increases in magnitude but remains constant in z direction. Now what is the difference? Earlier the field was constant, but this time the field is increasing. Okay, so what happens? Initially the equipotential surfaces will be at larger distance, but as we move above, the distance between two fields, two surfaces, will start decreasing. Okay, if we want to make one more closer to this one, is it clear? Because the direction or the magnitude of electric field increases, then we have to take care that the distance between two surfaces should become less and less if we move further upward. Next one is a single positive charge at the origin. If it is single, obviously it is in spherical shape. There is no thing, there is nothing new. And the next one is a uniform grid consisting long and equally spaced parallel charged wire in a plane. Okay, one, two wires are there which are parallel. Okay, and because of this we need to know what is the shape of equipotential surface. Now what happens in this case? The equipotential surfaces will be, suppose it is like a grid shape. Okay, let me make it correct. It is like a grid. So suppose it is something like this. Okay, these are the wires, and these wires, these are the charged wire. Okay, so if we say it like this, if we see the side view of this, it will be like this. The direction of the equipotential surfaces will be parallel to this one. Is it clear? When it is closed, when we are close to the wire, this is the grid, side view of the grid. Okay, when we are close, the equipotential surfaces are closely spaced. As we move away, the distance increases. Is it clear? So this is how the questions related to equipotential surfaces and electric field is there. In some questions, the value of electric field is given very small. Okay, in case of vectors like E1 I cap plus E2 J cap plus E3 K cap, and they give the value of R vector also, and then you need to know what is the potential difference. Just take the dot product of these two, you will get your answer. Okay, so these type of questions we are not doing. These are the simple put the value, get the result type question, and we are not doing these one. Okay, so it is already very late. Okay, so this is all for the day. Today there was no power since morning, and it's quite difficult to make video in absence of light in the room. So videos I am making very late. So today let us hold here. Tomorrow we'll do, and tomorrow we'll start a new segment, you can say, and that segment is capacitance. So before capacitance, we'll study some properties of conductor, then we'll start capacitance. Right? So that's all for today. Thank you.